teach you about Napoleon Bonaparte. Now, most of you know Napoleon Bonaparte was one of the greatest, most brilliant minds in the military in the 1800s. Now, his fall was surprisingly easy, yet it took a long course of action. But he started out as a normal child, except his dad was the representative of his home island. Forgot the name. Anyway, he was born there in like January 19th or something, and he had a partially wealthy family. Now, after he then saved his he then joined a revolutionary in the French Revolution. Forgot his name too. Now, basically, his life was normal. But until he switched sides, that's when it all came down. He switched sides, and then he rejoined the Republic. They overthrew the King of France. Isn't that right, Mason?
Yeah.
That's my cameraman. So, he is marked in history as a brutal dictator. But whether you see him as a normal commander or, as I said, a brutal dictator, you're both right. He was a corrupt little man. He was known for being little for nowadays. He was like 5'4", but for his age, actually, he was average. So, here's a famous quote by Napoleon. Give me 1,000 men and I'll take the world, is what I believe he said. If I'm wrong, just tell me. Maybe. But he overthrew most of Europe. Like, that's half of that. But this, he defeated Austria, and he defeated Russia, and most of Europe. The British always stand in his way. He took over most of Europe, not including Britain. They were one of the only remaining countries in Europe to survive. Now, his biggest mistake probably was the Russian invasion. Not because of the armies. He wanted to attack the armies, but he had to retreat. Why? The Russian army was weak and new and all that stuff. They were just a big country that was slow. How could Napoleon, one of the greatest commanders of all time, be defeated by such a small army? Who said anything about armies? The winter was harsh in Russia, and he had to retreat because of that. Then there's a revolution. And I'll tell you that after this short break. After the Russian invasion, I was banished one time. Then I escaped and went to Paris. The rest of Europe couldn't stand me, so they attacked me at Waterloo. With my army, I attacked them. I was lost, and I was sent back to exile. And I died of stomach cancer. Probably. Hopefully. Yeah.